in North America clashing once again. They previously met in the semifinals. It went in favor of Gen.G, but then before that, it was the grand finals of the first regional. FaZe Clan took that. This will be the series that gives one team the lead, the edge, and their record against each other. And I am all here for it. If you were watching the semifinals before this series, of course, you know how dominant both teams looked in their matchup. Gen.G, I'd say, looked a little bit superior just because of the sweep and how incredible they were against G2. I mean, of course, FaZe Clan were immaculate in their series alone, but for me personally, there was more of a fight from Space Station Gaming. Meanwhile, Gen.G, that's why they have that edge in the fan vote, in my opinion, just because of how great they look.
Gen.G, FaZe are probably the only other team that I think could contend with them in terms of their team synergy. Like, the way Gen.G move around the pitch is as if they're a hive. FaZe, they've been close to that. They've had that type of performance before, but I've seen it from Gen.G more than any other team. And Chronic, the big kid, the big pickup, gets the big goal to start it off.
Yep, and this is the guy that we're always highlighting, the new pickup for this team. Not too much hype around him before this split, but now he comes out on the roster and is making waves, and of course he's gonna make the first goal in favor of Gen.G.
How's it got a feel for Chronic? You make in your first, you get on Gen.G.
Ooh.
No, wait, hold on a second. First killer. Pulls Gen.G out of the way. FaZe execute the kickoff perfectly here on the 50.
Oh my goodness. You're talking about working like a hive mind. And this is essentially what FaZe Clan just did. All three players were participating in that goal. We had one going for a bump, which I believe was missed. Then typical getting the 50-50 challenge. And first killer just comes in, and that ball is glued on top of his car. Nice little dribble in, and an early response from FaZe.
FaZe absolutely capable of turning it on and
100%.
Having their own hive. This first killer going to go out wide on the wing here, but and turns it wide for Gen.G. Yeah.
I don't know, Joby. For FaZe Clan, like, with how well Stypical has been playing in this regional, that has been the biggest factor and standout performance out of, I'd say, all six players. I think you could talk a lot about Chronic, but Stypical, I've always had my questions around him. He has shown up and has done so much to impact and influence this team, especially when they get moving on offense, whether it's with bumps, demos, or winning challenges like we saw him do against Space Station.
I mean, all three of FaZe, Stypical, second on the team in assists per game. He's fourth in the league, first killer, by the way, at first, at 0.85 assists per game. But Typical and Mist hit at 4 and 5. So all three of FaZe's players are sitting in top 5 in assists per game. That shows you how good they are. But guess who else really worked well as a team? Gen.G starts off with a good 50. Chronic left for the 50. Ooh. That's not even intentional. I don't even know if that's intentional. Like, he goes up as if he's going to block the sidewall challenge, but Nolly takes the 50. Chronic's already left the wall, and he's like, oh yeah, okay, it's a perfect pop. Thanks, Nolly. And then Jack comes in, and it's a three-point passing play, but why is that a three-point passing play?
Listen, Jorby, sometimes you gotta roll the dice, and in that situation, Gen.G come out favorable, and Jack even jumped up early to go for that challenge too, but then backflipped to get back in position, so they're being aggressive, it's working out, they'll take it.
Oh.
And of course, the second goal, solid play from Gen.G. FaZe Clan are looking to get an early response, similar to how they got their first one.
Missed it, hit the post. FaZe left to get set up.
Oh my, why is wide open?
Caught in the gap.
What's going on?
Typical was thinking he was going to get a pass from first killer. This drops down.
Yep.
You see Typical, he's looking at Nolly. He sees Miss drop it. And as soon as he sees first killer, it's a little deceptive for Typical. The ball kind of looks initially as it drops that first killer's turning in on it. But then the ball bounces towards him. And as he turns around, he realizes, oh no, first killer's not as near to that ball as
another
I thought
one?
He was. And they get punished.
One?
Maybe they get here on the kickoff. Chronic extends the lead, makes it 4.
FaZe Clan put in very, very sticky situations, not only off this kickoff, but the previous goal, first killer and Typical out of position, disorientated. And now that's going to extend the lead even more for Gen.G. Truthfully, whenever we came in, I mean, we got a good response from FaZe Clan, but then somehow this game has just spiraled out of control for Gen.G.
Gen.G, in the last finals that they played, they did, oh, look at this from Nolly. He wanted the bump too. But their last finals, they would go through stomp through quarterfinals, semifinals, and then get to grands, and then you wouldn't see the same team. This is game one. Gen.G really want to prove something to people today.
Yeah, I mean,
his three grand final appearances, everyone wants to see if they can win one of them. Game one, looked like they won it.
Third time's the charm. These guys certainly have the experience. Jack is just going to take the players to Chronic. Chronic didn't want to take advantage of the spacer.
He had
actually made a mistake. Didn't have any boost, but I still think he could have put one on target. Here's another one from that's on target from him. He's going to look for a demo himself. Opportunities coming left and right for Gen.G. FaZe Clan, unable to respond. And good speed from Chronic. Maybe it's going to get a double tap. Goes straight down, and Chronic still has more boost to work with. Almost a flip reset, and they are just barraging this goal with several shots.
This is getting sloppy, but they're making it work. Gen.G, ball stolen away from him. Here comes First Killer, trying to push the last man out of the net. Typical slows it down. Chronic on the turnaround. Apparently Jack taking out Mist in the midfield. Now Nolly sends it right back to him. Redirect off the post, goal!
Everybody from FaZe Clan flat-footed. One demo came through from apparently Jack, and he's also in position to receive the clear. The shot wasn't on target, but the response and recovery from Nolly was beautiful. Best position he could ask for. 5-1. Say that this is dominant. I think it's a little bit of an understatement. Gen.G just continue their tear from the semifinals.
Well, thanks for showing up, FaZe, game one.
There's no way they do this to FaZe Clan. There's no way that they obliterate G2, they come out in the grand finals, and the same thing happens to FaZe Clan. I refuse to believe it, Jordan. This is just game one, okay?
It is only.
We're getting ahead of ourselves.
What is that touch from First Killer? He put that just on the side. Gen.G's nose.
Ooh,
it was going to be in. You're almost talking about Gen.G getting to Brazil. Chronic's going to get another goal. It's set up right here, 6-1. Oh my God, a hat trick for Chronic. Two goals for Nolly, one for apparently Jack. Everybody's eating.
And they're getting so physical. I didn't expect the demos to come out. I mean, certainly we've seen Gen.G be aggressive and go for demos in all of their series throughout this tournament alone, this regional alone. But I didn't expect it to be as dominant and at the forefront of their offense. But it has worked.
It's
been efficient. Another one, the Brazil guaranteed. I know Chad's going to be loving this one. The Brazil popping off for Gen.G. Jorby, what is going on for FaZe Clan?
Dude, Nolly got such a quick reset. First Killer comes across. Mist is actually trying to cover the air dribble bump, but it's too far behind the play. And it's just it all broke down for FaZe a million minutes ago. And they just got a reset into game two. As soon as that, really since that fourth goal went in, Gen.G on a rampage.
Yeah.
They have not stopped since the semifinals. They took a short break during FaZe Space Station, but now they're hardworking men here in game one.
It just seems like they have cracked the code and understand exactly how to make FaZe Clan panic and get in these very uncomfortable, tight situations. Not only are they controlling the boost effortlessly, but these demos, I can't tell you, Dorby, how impactful they have been. They've been bumping, getting in the way of them, winning the challenges. It felt like every single goal for Gen.G was off of some kind of physical play, besides this goofy one where all three players were also up, and Jack even was going for that shot. He backflipped before. It's just been ridiculous.
That play right there just makes absolutely no sense to me. They all three want to go for the same ball, even though Nolly's there going for the 50, but they're all like, okay, I'm gonna jump. And then Chronic's like, oh, cool, I'm in the air, and the ball's right in front of me. Let me just take this. And Jack is like, cool, I've recovered. Now I'm going to, calculated, 100%.
Calculated, Jorby.
When those kind of plays go in for you, Turtle, you just can't do anything wrong. Maybe
the pressure of getting number one seed is on this grand finals. This is a very important matchup. Yes, you know, they're going to be playing in Rotterdam. You guaranteed a major spot. But you want to set yourself up for success at that major, and this win is going to do just that, playing against the second seed from OCE versus, you know, potentially Falcons or another European team. So a lot on the line for FaZe Clan, Gen.G. And of course, you want to see some type of response from FaZe Clan.
See how FaZe can respond. The best part about getting scored on seven times in one game is Gen.G only get one win out of it.
Yep.
Now they can reset, miss. See if FaZe can get set up. They got out-positioned. Really just outplayed in general. Now they drop it down. It's typical.
Oh my.
Little dolphin dive and trying to make it work. Saw First Killer try to force the issue. Missed. We'll keep it going in front. Typical no boost, but pops it up nicely. And Chronic's called off by apparently Jack. Saw First Killer coming in. That gets a big clear out for Gen.G.
Good possession, though. Back pass from First Killer. all the way to typical, which leads into more pressure. And Nolly's gonna miss off the backboard, uncharacteristic from him. A good midfield pass, Abjack expected miss to turn on it and go for the shot, which is why he flipped so early. No shot came through.
Whoa.
As a result, we've got still 0-0, but a lot of FaZe fan pressure.
You even saw from Nolly, he kind of saved First Killer's attempted possession closer to the blue corner, where he doesn't go for the ball or the read. He knows how Jack wants to get there, so he just plants his car right under him where when he lands. And that, First Killer, and that killed FaZe's earlier possession, but they've done a good job hanging on to the ball and forcing it back over to the blue corner. First Killer with no boost, preventing Chronic from getting back, and now he's got to pass the typical. Sees First Killer on the wing, can't do much about it. Mist is also going to hang back here, seeing the midfield possession losing control to Gen.G. First Killer, big boom over to Typical. Turns off ball cam to get the read, just to make sure he could push it forward, but he ran out of boost and couldn't do much afterwards.
Regardless of the fact that FaZe Clan are yet to score, you can tell they have adapted and changed things up. Much cleaner rotations, very tight whenever they push forward. They're shadowing each other well, and it also reminds me of what Rold is, the coach, got to mention in his interview yesterday, Jorby, where he said that FaZe Clan, a lot of times they'll come out in game one, have a rough start. That's what happened against Team Axel. But in game two, they were able to be more confident, get aggressive, and match the pace. It seems like they're doing that in game two against Gen.G.
Jack, in his post-game interview, said he felt like FaZe were going to win this series, or their series against FaZe Station, but that he felt more confident against them after their last series in the quarterfinals in the Fall Cup, where they fell in seven games. So far, FaZe, like you said, they've adapted, and you've seen that adjustment. We've seen them leave challenges on the table and get a couple of transitions. First Killer leaves it down, difficult, too light, and FaZe forced to hang on to midfield. Start with First Killer, great pass over to Mist. Typical went the whole way back for boost, so it's up to First Killer to set it up. And now Typical comes from the midfield line. Excellent control there from Nolly to get it back to Jack. Gen.G surviving, but can't break through the midfield.
FaZe Clan putting on a lot of shots, a fury of shots. So far, seven to their name compared to Gen.G's one shot, but one demo from Abjack could change things, and you can tell the momentum has shifted quite a bit. But as soon as I say that, it's bolted all the way down to the other side. FaZe Clan, a lot of illusions thrown at the defense of Gen.G.
Wow.
A couple of fakes. Miss going for backward double taps himself. And this ball is a high floater for the net of FaZe Clan, and Miss. The Guardian Angel is there to get the touch.
Truly sitting on the option coverage underneath to defend that double. Now it's popped up in front. It's a little awkward for Mist. He gets chipped, but the ball hits the post. First Killer carry gets dunked off the backboard. All of FaZe are kind of hurrying back. They're all on low boost. They're looking for small pads. Mist finally gets his corner, and he has to defend the shot. He's got it. First Killer racing towards him. Can't get the ball away from Chronic. Now apparently Jack flying to the sky. Off the ceiling. Oh, it's a little wide and maybe intended by Chronic, but it's going to be taken back. Nobody was available for the follow-up. It's got to be Chronic to force the ball back into the corner. Final minute, still scoreless. Gen.G finally has some pressure, but Typical relieves it with a big 50.
That's huge for FaZe Clan. Dealt with the most pressure all game long, but an early shot, maybe a follow-up denied by the defense of FaZe Clan. Gen.G, they have found their stride, working like a well-oiled machine on offense, but they've only got about 33 seconds until this ball drops into OT.
Jack avoids the bump, gets it over to Nolly, who finds Chronic downfield to commit. But Nolly will recover quickly. First Killer secures the boost.
Touch.
The pass is only missed. He sees First Killer.
He's
going to take the go-ahead. He gets the chip on Jack, but Chronic covers him. Chronic going to steal that midfield boost. Nolly going to look for him downfield. He connects. First touch. Falls down. Jack's in the air. It's light going to be taken away by FaZe. The end of regulation. Here comes Gen.G. Off the board.
Chronic
denied. In front of the box. Jack's too late. Missed.
There's
only
so
eight
much
boost.
Face. There's
the
so much
clear.
Face, Jorby.
Does he keep it in the air? Can he find First Killer? Nolly kills it. We're in overtime, Turtle.
Everybody from Gen.G pushed up and extended in that final attempt on net. And FaZe Clan were not able to punish, even with all that space. Maybe they'll be able to punish here. No, denied by Chronic. Typical. How do you get a better 50-50? He doesn't. And we're back to a midfield battle. Unless Abjack gets over one,
what?
He does off the crossbar and down. It's not enough.
Game two feels like the series I thought I was walking into.
This is what we expected, Jorby.
Apparently, Jack gonna flick it over one. Missed. Loses the 50 to Chronic. Punches it in reverse, and FaZe may turn their fortunes here. I hope everyone a little farther off the rotation. Apparently Jack next up. Nolly with no boost on his side. Chronic gonna follow this next touch up. Gets the touch underneath, but saved by First Killer. Chronic trying to keep the pressure up. Nolly coming into support, and it's gonna be a close ball, and apparently Jack has to protect the midfield. Typical's making life difficult for Gen.G as he pushes the ball forward. Another 50 for Sip. Chronic, a lot of boost, but he's gotta protect the ball, and missed. Grab it. He's got it. Gen.G looks solid right now on defense. And he gets the ball away from First Killer. Killer across, and a big touch will stop Gen.G on defense.
Oh, but there's all this space, and Nolly's gonna go for a bump. He finds it. First Killer's gonna get a demo himself. And now this has quickly transitioned down the other side. One team can't hold on to possession for too long. If you overextend, that could be the death of you in this OT. You were talking about Typical being annoying and being a nuisance. For me, it's been First Killer. He's been taking so many midfield boosts on the side of FaZe Clan, and that's weakened a lot of these counterattacks from Gen.G.
Yeah, great cash from Typical on the back wall. It froze Gen.G on the line. They couldn't go for a challenge. They had to wait. Now FaZe are back on offense. Watch out for First Killer, not going to do much for FaZe there. Apparently Jack on the transition, forces missed up. Free ball on the backboard. Jack deletes
going,
one.
Nolly
has a free shot. He takes the pass. Missed from Jack. Chronic in the air.
Ooh,
off the post, it's open. Goal! Gen.G take two.
Ring around the rosy here in the box of FaZe Clan. From the right side to the left side. And finally, Nolly can smack it down the middle. All throughout FaZe Clan's defense, threading the needle. The precision comes through, and we get the game-winning shot. We were scoreless for so long, and Gen.G can break the drought.
Just enough 50s, enough challenges to break them down.
Wow.
Jack diving in for that demo.
Yeah.
FaZe have called a timeout, and Roll Diz is going to have to speak to the boys because right now they made a good adjustment. They didn't get scored on six more times in that game, but they couldn't get the offense going. I know this sounds ridiculous, Turtle, but nine shots for FaZe, I feel like I don't remember most of those. There was a couple of them that were quality, but the rest of them, Gen.G really commanded the game on offense.
Yeah, we didn't get the usual flair from FaZe Clan that we see in almost every single series. I mean, these guys are a powerhouse when it comes to the mechanics, especially First Killer. So I think there's a lot of responsibility on his shoulders to step up, because I've seen a lot of moments where typically he would come out with a goal to his name where he's got a dribble, where he's got a nice flick by himself. You've got Typical being a nuisance and Mist, of course, holding it down as the third man. They were connecting whenever it came to the transition, so I don't have any critiques or any issues with how they were transitioning on offense. But for me, I'm looking at the shots and what we're getting out of First Killer particularly. He's got to take initiative on offense, because if you're not, you know, executing well, Jorby, it doesn't matter if you can transition. Eventually, Gen.G will find a way to slip through.
I mean, that's kind of the problem with Gen.G, right? So all weekend, I feel like, or really the last 2 weeks, talking about Gen.G's immaculate defense. I can hear Achieves in my head, because that's the one thing that he's been most, he's so smart. It's the one thing he's been most impressed with with Gen.G. And so, like, a lot of on these pushes, I do feel like First Killer is doing things to create plays with his mechanics, with his smarts. We've seen FaZe try to draw up those plays with the layoffs.
Right here, what's happening?
They are trying.
But in that situation, the first replay we see is Typical and First Killer. It's almost a 2v2 situation, potentially a 2v1 situation. First Killer is kind of flat-footed. He's not moving up forward. He's not shadowing closely. I think that his positioning in relation to his teammates has been somewhat off in this series, and that's a very quick and easy adjustment. If he gets a little bit more aggressive, I think that could be the difference maker. And after the timeout, things could change moving on in the series, and they're going to have to change for FaZe Clan.
FaZe, you remember in their match against Axel, in the quarterfinals, game one shocked them when Axel took the game, but then it was just one adjustment for FaZe, and they were able to get it done. They made an adjustment last game, but they couldn't get any goals in the net, so they're gonna need a couple of more here against Gen.G. FaZe, one of the best teams at adapting mid-series. They can absolutely do it, but Gen.G, a tough cookie to crack, no doubt.
Yeah, and they're not going to come up with a lot of mistakes. Speaking of mistakes, the issue is force, and a mistake comes out on the side of FaZe Clan.
Oh, he gets
maybe
bumped.
Opportunity created by Nolly, and apparently there was a bump on the field. Where was it, Joe? I didn't see it.
Nolly bumps Typical, because I'm thinking, okay, why is it missed positions force Typical's challenge, And he's wondering, wait, why does Nolly just get a free touch on the ball in the corner? It's because Nolly chipped Typical, got him on the ball, and Typical gets revenge. Goal right on the kickoff.
Reminiscent of game one, similar ways this has developed in front of us. Gen.G get the first goal, but FaZe Clan are able to respond quickly. Now the goal is to make sure this doesn't get out of control and turn into a Brazil FaZe Clan.
That's the Brazil setup? Is that what you're saying?
I mean, that's what it feels like, bro. We got baited in game one. I don't want to see that happen again.
Fair enough. Here comes Nolly. Wanted to set it up, but Jack, there was no way he could commit to that play. No opening. He'll file in behind Chronic. FaZe. Seen them put on a flurry. Never mind.
That's just ridiculous from Nolly. I don't even know why he's going up for that, but it works out. I'm not going to question it.
He's going for the dunk. You don't get it? Chronic's there. No problem.
Oh, look at the space, too. Nolly. Oh, man. Nolly was playing out of his mind.
Did you see no fear there from Mist, too? He saw Jack barreling towards him to bump him, and Mist just didn't deviate from his path. Nothing happened on that play, but that's the kind of thing that kind of trips you up against Gen.G, right? Mist trying not to blink. But it's hard to blink when you're dead. Apparently, Jack takes two of them out. And Chronic gonna take it himself. Oh, what a save on the inside. First killer pitches it. And he said, no dice this time, Gen.G.
He flies across the goal line. It was falling in. You could see that ball crossing the goal line halfway through and out. First killer keeping things tied up. And now maybe a transition this pass into the midfield. But Mist is taken out. Abject making sure to have an impact, even if he's rotating back, and then on offense, he's hitting him with counterattack shots.
Big clear for first killer, missed downfield, he gets chipped by Nolly. Chronic gonna follow in behind him. Abjack already downfield. He's able to receive it. He's good for Gen.G. Oh, Nolly gets it away from first killer, who tried to play him on the 50. Just gonna wait, because he sees the, or excuse me, first killer waiting, as he sees the boomer downfield. Jack forcing him to contest high. Oh, wow. Two quick transitions, but nothing on top of it. Jack waiting downfield underneath. Made it awkward. Typical made it work. Nolly gets back. Does he get the 50? Doesn't get around two. Miss just gets around him. But it's Nolly who gets the boost. First killer gets the clear, but that's just Gen.G reloading. Jack sends a long one, and first killer, I guess he's also got a cannon. Nolly sends it back. I don't know what's going to happen on these transitions. The ball's flying. It's supersonic.
Yeah, but that's important from Nolly to get up there, even if he's on his own half, just to get in the face of the striker from FaZe Clan. Makes it that much more difficult to find an angle. Abjack is going to get this clear down the other side, and I've noticed a lot of space in this midfield. It's up for grabs right now. I haven't seen one team be dominant with possession. A back-and-forth game, which I think is more along the lines of what we expected given the results coming into this grand final. Typical, nice touch off the backboard. We'll see if that midfield space is. Something about it feels like there's going to be an early shot, an eager transition all the way from the midfield that might slip in if that rotation is caught off.
Jack recognizing first killer cutting in, and he just takes him out of the play. That has to be so annoying if you're FaZe. You feel like you're finally getting something set up. You're finally weaving around Gen.G, and then here comes a full-bodied Fennec to just take you out of the stadium. And here comes another one. Nolly takes out another. Chronic says, here you go, Jack. He gets bodied off the play. First killer, it looked like he was the one to get there. Now Jack has to race back, collects the midfield boost. Nolly sitting back, has to wait for Typical. But he's lost the touch, and Jack has a full tank to receive it. He wants the reset, he's got it, but can't get it on target. Taken away. Nolly gonna play a deep third on this. He's finally gonna come in as FaZe try to slow down. Gen.G just will not give FaZe the space. They're willing to protect that clear, but as soon as FaZe... As soon as Gen.G get this ball in front of the box, Jack is happy to wait. Typical, using a lot of boost to stay near that. And he gets the 50, but Nolly gets back. Nolly's playing, he's playing optimism there. And he still gets back to get that 50, forces Mist to get the air dribble turn.
Well, it's the trust that Gen.G have in their teammates. They're oftentimes just given so many opportunities because they're optimistically positioning themselves. And here's another example. Abjack believes in Nolly and his ability to get past two players. It's wide open from the midfield. That space catches FaZe all over the place. And Gen.G can take the lead, and they will.
Look, I don't know what Jack put in his water, but all I'm going to say is Hydro homies winning big today.
Hydro up.
Jack, wait a minute. It's not over. First killer ties the series game.
Ask and you shall receive. I wanted to see first killer step up in this game. I thought they needed it, and certainly they do. Ties it up 2-2. to the backboard read, a nice little double tap, and they tie things up in style. That's the way to do it.
In the game, FaZe are very much still down by two in the series. Chronic. Not gonna get much going there in Gen.G. Gonna get deleted. Apparently Jack tasted his own medicine. Then FaZe don't do anything with the ball. Jack just gets the touch. Another big clear. FaZe are gonna get a free look. Pass to miss. Nothing underneath. First killer hard shot, but wide, and Chronic's there anyway. And another overtime. Both teams turtle. Excellent in overtime this season. 70% win percentage for FaZe. 66% win percentage for Gen.G.
Oh my, on the backboard? Okay. I'm a little bit scared, Joby. These goals have been so good, they make me forget about the series score. That's how good they are. Ridiculous stuff.
You and me both.
Here we go from the corner. I believe in miss right now with these third man rotations. He's been solid, unshakable. But with those demos, Joby, you never know what can happen. Gen.G have been so physical in the grand finals.
Oh, first killer. Was expecting a touch from Jack. Jack had left it. All the Gen.G, they need to refuel. Chronic gets the back corner. Jack had gotten the midfield. Now he gets the ball. No, he missed it! But a big dive! Nolly dives into the ground. Chronic, he faked it. And that throws FaZe in the midfield, allowed Gen.G to get a clear, but now they're on small pad duty. Wait, reverse killer! Oh, save from Chronic! In their tensest moments. Chronic, a pass over to Nolly. The 50 taken away. Gen.G, just when you think you've got them on ice, they find a way to melt it.
I do love that idea from FaZe Clan. Given how much space there is in the midfield and how fast these teams are rotating back to their own net, if you utilize the ceiling and pass it right back to yourself in the midfield space, farther away from the goalkeeper, could set up a better opportunity. Here's first killer looking for a better opportunity himself, and it's all by himself, rather. Winning 50-50 is going forward, but I guess it's not enough against Abjack.
Abjack hit that right on the corner of his Fennec. Now Chronic having to defend against first killer. Nolly helps out. First killer drills it. Front shot! Oh, Jack jumped for it! The man has got a crystal ball! He knew exactly where it was going! He knew exactly when to jump! Gen.G! They ain't building bricks! They're building a dam! They can't get through the face! Here's from Mist, and Nolly's there! Oh. Or apparently Jack gets the ball back downfield. About 2 minutes of overtime done. And does anything develop here for Gen.G? First killer wants a way out. Off the ceiling, the reset back over to Typical, who's gonna stay on the back wall. Maybe it dies here for FaZe.
Best few looks for FaZe Clan within the last 30 seconds. It's so difficult because you're up against a team that seems to be able to read the future. A nice pre-save or pre-jump save from Abjack, but the demo is going to open up even more. And Abjack is alone in the net. He's not going to get the save because it's just off the crossbar. No accuracy for FaZe.
This man is liquid. You can't hold him down. Up high, Nolly. Pass in front. Chronic missed his contact. It was a hard pass. Jack protecting now the back line as the rest of Gen.G have to retreat. They got the midfield line, all the small pads. Difficult though, he gets the catch. He gets it over Chronic, and this is gonna force Jack back. We'll see if FaZe can get set up.
It's so important how you transition out and carry this ball from your own end. A clear like this is right into the hands of Typical. Ideally, you want to see and snipe Abjack out on the other side, because FaZe Clan, now they're given a free transition. And they can apply some pressure. They've been doing it for the past minute, minute and a half, it feels like. Maybe
seven
a better 50-50. Something needs to go the way of FaZe Clan. You think, Jordan.
Seven saves for Gen.G Turtle, but 10 for FaZe, and they might need 11. Mist gives it right to him. Typical says, apparently, Jack, get off my pitch. Typical gonna drop it down for first killer, but Jack comes back. Across the corner. It's a deep rotation as Chronic gets deleted on the backside, but Nolly with a full tank. He's just roaming around, collecting pads, staying right in the line of play. Chronic quick up to the ball. He's first up to the ball. Now Nolly, hands up back.
Wow,
Jack! What a save! Misses, that's cool, Jack. But I'm also an absolute star defender. Yeah. Now first killer says, I got you. Ooh, apparently Jack walked out of the way. Missed shot on target, denied by apparently Jack. Here comes another one. Denied, but it's a double commit. Gen.G awkward. Miss got Google stopped.
Typical.
Taken away by apparently Jack. So many layers that you can't find the bottom of this Gen.G defense.
Each team somehow finding that crystal ball, able to read the future, knowing where these teams are trying to shoot, relying on a free jump to stay in OT. And it hasn't just been one side, one defense standing up and accepting the challenge. Here comes Chronic. 4:20 on the clock. OT ended.
Well, FaZe, they're going to be feeling some Chronic pain after that one. Big goal at 4:20. Chronic put Gen.G up in sweeping fashion. One more to go, Turtle.
We're already on match point.
One more.
How are we already on match point? When did this happen?
Bro, it was almost a 5-minute overtime, dude. We had like a 2-minute one. That was over. That was little league. This overtime, that's the bigs.
That game was so close individually. Sad scorelines aside, you could tell there were opportunities. There were moments for FaZe Clan and Gen.G both to finish things off. But Gen.G, simply put, they have the ice. They are hungry. Third time is the charm. They made it to the grand finals again. And now they want to win a grand finals in one of these regional events. And they just might do it unless FaZe Clan can do the impossible, it feels like, and get this reverse sweep.
Here's an insane stat for you, Turtle. Shout out to Direct.
Let's hear it.
Gen.G are in this tournament, or actually, no, I think in all their games. I think it's just this tournament. They're 15-0 when they score first.
15-0
when they score first.
That's
no one else has that.
That's absurd.
That is.
It just adds so much more importance now to whoever can strike first. FaZe Clan have been able to respond to that first goal quickly. And another one. We just talked about it. You cannot let these guys score first. They're 15-0. And 3 seconds in, Abjack takes charge.
Apparently, jacked up back into FaZe's net. That happened real quickly, didn't it, Turtle?
And look at the smiles on the face cams of Gen.G. There's been so much hype. If you were watching the semifinals and looking at the cams, Abjack, every time a goal would go in, he'd be screaming, he'd be popping off. You know the mentality is there. The vibes are there. Feeling confident in this matchup. Taking out Mist. First killer was looking for a demo. Now there's a fake from Chronic near his goal. What are you doing, you madman? It worked, but man, it looked risky.
FaZe is going to need to take some more risks. This one looking like it's done and dusted already. How many times do you got to put that ball on? How many times can you try it? It doesn't matter. You dial up the saucy pass. Here's another one. Is that going to go in? No. Hey, how about this one? What does Mist have? Oh, wait, nothing. That's right over to Nolly. And now Gen.G are on the turnaround. First killer. It's a great touch that actually forces all of Gen.G to wait for the ball. And FaZe will try again here. First killer got the 50 underneath. Typical and Mist, both committed on the play. First killer's going to help out with that. Mist on the backside. Jack gets there first.
What do FaZe Clan have up their sleeve to take down the hive mind that is Gen.G? It is so difficult to break through this team. You get a demo, you get a bump on that third man, but then there's another player from Gen.G who's also taking you out. Chronic, the double tap, the angle of a lifetime. He goes by himself. Normally you would pass this, Norby. You pass that. Why are you shooting it?
Because he's winning. Because every time Chronic touches the ball, it turns to gold.
I can't argue with
when you do no wrong, Turtle, you just go for the shot.
Yep.
Nolly early in the series, he was hitting clips. Apparently Jack was hitting chassis and Chronic was finishing FaZe Clan off. Now 2-0. Jack, another redirect. They're just getting free redirects now.
Even with the transitions, like you'll see Gen.G go for a pass between their own defense, one big clear, and somebody, what feels like 90% of the time, is already up in the air downfield. They are so comfortable with each other. The trust between these teammates and all three of them has arrived, and so has FaZe Clan. Hello, welcome to game number 4.
Finally, they find a leak through this defense. Apparently, Jack just loses that touch, and Chronic was trying to get on the ball side, but Mist absolutely knew what he was up to. Got him off the wall, and got him out of the net.
This whole time, Jordy, we've been sweet-talking Gen.G. FaZe Clan have been throwing attempts at the net of Gen.G. It's not like they're just sitting down taking the beating here.
Oh.
Or maybe they are. Or maybe they just are. Abjack so high up in the air. The spike down. Make it 3-1.
Gen.G just let in the jab so they can bring in the right hook. Beautiful shot from Jack. Great setup from Nolly. And right when you think FaZe can start getting it figured out, and he embodied again. Oh, look, a fake kickoff now. That's pure confidence. Jack's wide open. Pass in front. Rips it hard. Wait, it's going to be Chronic. He's coming with speed, but he didn't have enough boost. A little too speedy for him.
All right, we'll see, though. FaZe Clan, it's denied early. Still, there are opportunities. We can't express that enough. I mean, FaZe Clan, there's chances for them. They're thin, and they're far and few between, but they have had looks, opportunities at the net, like this one for first kill of the demo, and they're fighting for that number one seed.
Such an important demo here. Chronic only got one pad as he rotated back, and Nolly getting demoed on the play absolutely left him stranded. He gets onto the back wall because he's thinking at least a challenge is going to come out. I'll be able to respond with 12, but your first man getting deleted leaves you stranded. Great play from FaZe.
Very well thought out. They have not let go of the confidence. Their mental has not slipped. It doesn't matter what the scoreline is. If you have to get a reverse sweep, it doesn't matter what it takes. We know FaZe Clan are capable, but they've got to unload and unleash every single weapon in their arsenal if they want to take down Gen.G.
This is the chance for them now. I think the FaZe, you see them, it's much more concentrated now, the demo game.
Yes.
They are just trying to delete the Gen.G code from the game. Can they? Can they tie it up? More importantly, can they win? Jack says, that's cool, but I also got hacker skills, bro. Here comes another one. Touched underneath FaZe, though. Mr. C playing such a deep third on the opposite side of the field, hoping that play would come across. Instead, Gen.G get it back into the corner. Chronic coming in from midfield. Got a straight-up challenge missed for the ball. Nolly going back to the corner boost. This should be FaZe ball.
How do you throw off Gen.G and their timing? I mean, whenever we listened to Abjack in his interview after obliterating G2, he was talking about how things were flowing so well for him and his teammates. He knew exactly where every single one of them were at any given moment, and the timing on when they go for demos, when they go for opportunities, it hasn't skipped a beat. FaZe Clan are trying to throw that off and break that rotation down. Demos haven't worked, but they have managed to be successful. Two goals. They need one more to tie things up, and they're looking for it.
If Gen.G pull this off, it'll be the best record an NA team on Championship Sundays has ever had.
This might be
it. And they might get it! And they spread the lead out! Two goals up! Nolly finishes the touch! Chronic sets him up on the double-triple holy moly dish! And Nolly, he eats it!
And it just might be the final dagger thrown at the FaZe Clan defense. All of the armor stripped off. And they are left vulnerable, Jorby. This might be the end of FaZe Clan and the victory that Gen.G have been looking for every single regional, every grand finals. Third time just might be the charm.
Typical tries to get it set up, but first killer has to come back. He's got no boost. Mist was playing it deep behind him, barely gets to the ball. Gen.G, they've been waiting for this all split. They've tried twice and they failed. But this time, the third time, it seems to be the charm for Gen.G.
Yep.
FaZe cannot get set up on offense. Jack, there he is again. 18 boost in the tank. Typical once more, but there's no more time on the clock. Gen.G ransack North America, your Fall Invitational champion.
Absolute destruction. Gen.G storming through North America. They make the move. People questioning, was it worth it? Was it the right decision? Is this roster one that is going to succeed in this region? They made the major, and now they have gotten themselves a grand final victory in the Fall Invitational. FaZe Clan, they tried their best. They really put their heart and their efforts there on the field. Everything they had in the tank was used up, but at the end of the day, it was not enough to overpower what is Gen.G.
All I'm going to say is that in the pre-show, Gibbs had his top five teams most likely to win.
Yeah,
Rotterdam.
Roast Gibbs.
He put Gen.G at third. Hell, third. I think it's time to change that up. Third, bro? Third?
Listen,
this team is not third most likely in NA to win Rotterdam. They look like the most likely team to win out of this region right now.
And things could change, obviously, given it's a LAN environment. But if they can figure out how to translate this style, this confidence, you keep saying it and I keep saying it because I love the term, the hive mind play style, because it genuinely feels like every single one, equally impactful and equally important on this field. It's not just Chronic taking charge. It's not just Nolly doing his thing. It's not just Abject being the leader. It's all three of them equally playing a role on this roster. And if they can translate that in Rotterdam, we've got another thing coming, because that will be a sight to see.
I do still think you have to look out for FaZe. Besides that first game, those back three games were a lot closer. I still think they had a lot of the same issues that they struggled with on offense mainly. But man, Gen.G have made a statement today. I'm really curious what the rest of the desk thinks. And Gibbs, you need to apologize. Thank you.
Where are you ranking them now, Gibbs? Are they number one?
Hey, you know, they're looking pretty good. That might be the best day we've ever seen from a North American team in one day, where they 4-0 G2 and then come out in 4-0 FaZe, two of the top teams in North America, and putting up nearly four goals per game. They looked unbelievable through today. So if they play like that, they're going to win every single game at the future. But we'll see. We'll see if they can do that again. That was amazing.
It seems like against North America, they're not going to have many problems here at all, given as long as they can keep up the performance. They lost five games, Achieves, across the entire Invitational.
Yeah, I was kind of talking about it while watching that last series in the middle of game four, and I was just like, watching Gen.G today has just been everything that comes up is like, cool, ace is up, we win again. Yeah. Like, you could not go wrong. If you were on Gen.G today, it didn't matter who you were playing against. I mean, when you drive circles around G2, things are going to look good. And they go out there against FaZe. Yeah, there's a lot more stability on that FaZe Clan defense. They had to work through it and make sure they got around cleanly. But at the same time, man, they just hit flip resets over everybody all day.
It's just unbelievable. Because FaZe, they did battle back in a lot of those games and made them close at the least. But at the end of the day, it's a 4-0 sweep, and Gen.G just hitting everything. And Chronic, you know, he's coming out of nowhere, basically, playing on like a few bubble teams. And then he's like, I'll join two Europeans, and now we're the number one team in North America. So he must be feeling fantastic. Apparently, Jack and Nolly absolutely as well, because that move, well worth it for sure.
Incredible performances from every member of Gen.G in what is clearly the most dominant day of Rocket League a North American team has played in a while. They shake the grand final monkey off their back, and I want to hear it from the players themselves. Nolly is here with us to talk about the win.
Hello, hello, hello. How are we doing, everyone?
Oh, Nolly, long time no see, my friend. And, you know, I think you can finally let those emotions pour out. And I just want you to take me through what it feels like right now to finally, third time's the charm, win the Fall Invitational.
I'll be honest, like, nothing's coming to mind. Like, I don't know what to say. Like, it was a big gamble, and it's paid off.
It was definitely a big gamble. And tell me what it was like when you told your family and friends, you know, I'm going to move across the Atlantic Ocean and I'm going to go try and play a video game in North America.
Well, all my family is supportive. Like, they watch every single one of my games, you know, from like my cousins, my grandparents and parents. And I told them a week before I moved to NA, basically. I was like, look, I'm moving to play. They always knew I wanted to play in North America anyway. They just didn't realize how soon. And it's honestly paid off so much. Like, I don't know what to say.
Yeah, I mean, as a parent, I think they could just offer nothing but praise to you right now, and they're probably so proud of everything you've accomplished, not only in your entire career, but just the short 6 weeks that it's been that you've been in North America. I mean, it has been, talk about a skyrocket to the top. You guys take the number one seed going into Rotterdam. What has been the critical kind of moment behind this team's success?
Just honestly, like, us being so open with each other as a team. Like, we do have the best environment in whole of Rocket League. Like, nobody comes close. As soon as we lose a game, we talk about it. You know, I mean, we only lost one game in playoffs, and that was to V1, so we didn't have to do much talking. But yeah, just us being so, like, well-knit together.
Well, you bring up, you know, being able to talk about that, and I'd like to talk, how do you guys, we know the hours Abject puts in, we know the hours you put in, the hours Chronic puts in, how do you balance the work, fun, life, all of it all into one? And, you know, how do you deal with that with your mental health and things like that?
It, honestly, like, it is tough, you know, moving away from, like, family and friends, where the only person I talk to every day is my team. Well, the only people I talk to is my team. It is. It's hard. I mean, luckily we're winning, so like it's not being as affected as much. But I will say it's difficult. I mean, we're going to Rotterdam, and then I'll be back home for Christmas. Same with Jack. But I don't know. Like I don't know what to say. I'm just so happy right now.
Yeah, that's obvious. I mean, the moment we see how you guys won is just smiles across all your faces. And I've known you've been on the grind for so long, just trying to break into the top tier, and you've finally done it. And I want to know, who do you think is going to be your stiffest competition at this major? It's going to be...
I want to play them so bad, because I have a track record of in teams who kick me, you know. That's no diss to them. I love them all on that team. I'm still friends with them. But I want to beat them more than anyone.
No, it's that competitive edge. That's why you're here. That's why you're one of the best, is you always want to beat the people that kick you, and it's fun to see. And, you know, I'm looking forward to seeing you perform. I remember seeing you in London in the hallways backstage, just saying, I'm happy to see you. Like, you of all people, I think I'm happiest to see, because I've known how long this journey has been. And you talked about your family, you talked about your friends. They've been so supportive. So I'd like to just kind of offer up the floor to you right now. What do you have to say to all the people that have supported you along this way?
Just keep supporting. I wouldn't be where I am without the amount of support I get from everyone. It's surreal, and I want to do a free Evo. You know, you told me to say that, but I'll put that out there.
Nolly, it has been such a pleasure getting to watch you play. I'm looking forward to seeing you in Rotterdam, and thank you for the incredible weekend. It was so fun seeing some top tier Rocket League.
Thank you for having me.